guys, I am Chris Kaler.
And I'm Amber Foster, Kyuujin Cosplay, and today we are back again, you guys, with the Queen's Gambit episode 6 show.
Almost done, actually. How many episodes? 8?
7.
7?
So we're almost through.
Ooh, okay. Last episode, we went to, well, we went, Harry came back.
Benny came back.
Yes, and we learned a lot from both. Beth has been dealing with the death of her mother, so she's not feeling comfortable in the house alone. She looked for, you know, company and an escape so that she doesn't have to face her feelings. Playing at, like, you know, she's acting like the grown-up, yet at the same time, she's still trying to act her age. It's crazy. Like, it's confusing because it's like there are two sides of her personality when it comes to maturity, and she doesn't really know which one she's supposed to be now that her mom is dead. We'll see how that develops, but yeah, Harry came, he told her about his feelings for her, he told her that, you know, maybe he wanted more with her, but then as soon as it got real, they slept together, but as soon as it got real, she evaded. She changed subjects, she went back to chess, she wasn't ready for emotions, so he left. He did teach her a lot of interesting things, you know, how to maybe not be so tunnel visioned about her strategies, so that was good. And she went and faced Benny.
And she won the freaking game.
Yep. So now Benny has been, she got advice from both guys about her destructive habits. Both of them are saying, you know, careful, you know, don't pay attention to what you're doing because you could end up destroying yourself. And she doesn't want to listen, but it's a good thing that they said it. And Benny seems to want to, you know, keep her close and teach her a few things and maybe keep her in check before Paris. So we'll see how that goes. Mm-hmm. She's on her way to New York to learn from him. So that's cool. And we'll see how that relationship goes. He said no sex, so maybe...
but maybe that could change.
That could change.
Two episodes, guys.
That could change, but then the fact he said it is important. So we'll see how that plays out between the two. So yeah.
All right.
So without further ado, let's jump in this episode. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, guys, if you want to see more of this.
And ring that bell to not miss it next time.
Yes. So yeah, let's go. I mean, it's big. In New York, it's really big. It's big, but aside from that, I'm actually happy that in the show, they showed us a New York apartment that looks like a New York apartment.
Are you thinking about, like, Gossip Girl?
I'm thinking about Friends.
True.
In Gossip Girl, they're all rich.
There's space in the closet.
I thought I was gonna get a couch.
No, I said living room.
I mean, those
that's
are...
That's how I stand shape, then.
Those are life experiences.
Really? Sure.
It gives color to your character.
There's no booze in the apartment.
Didn't think there would be.
This easy. Keeping her in check.
You know from your tournament experience, you can't rely on your opponent setting himself up for a queen sacrifice or a surprise mate with a knight and a rook. That's who you are. You're bored with ordinary chess, even when it's played by grandmasters. You're bored in the way you're probably bored when you read Ruin Fine's endgame analysis. And you haven't done anything like what I'm making you do now. We're playing serious chess. Workman, like.
Oh my
chess,
god, this is so accurate.
Soviets.
It's true that she doesn't focus on the basics of chess that much. It bores her. And that's how she called Burggraf too. You know, he was boring and he used robotic tactics.
That's how he beat her.
I wonder who that could be. Hey! Right on time. Come on in. Come in.
You're not gonna go to sleep.
Hilton Wexler and Grandmaster Arthur Levertov.
Can you
Chan? Hi. Hello, Bet. I'm Cleo.
She's totally French. And if you're wondering, yes, we do kiss on both cheeks when we meet people.
Positions that never come up in our...
Let's do a simultaneous. You, we play all of us.
Okay.
Time control?
Let's play speed chess.
Oh. Snitch. We can think on your time.
I want to try it.
I know, but you're
not so good at that, remember?
I'll bet you 10 I can beat you.
Okay, let's see this. I'm like mesmerized by those games. Okay, hey. Two.
Just Benny then.
Yep. I mean, he's been teaching her.
Good job, Beth.
Her pride couldn't take another loss.
Let's do it again.
She's gonna try to get back all those fights.
After one night and many days learning with him, she's good as peaches.
It matters to look at the basics, you know? Even if she finds it boring,
yeah.
That's how you start. You can't rush this.
Oh, she had a grudge.
Yeah, it's definitely that.
It'd be such a pleasure. Don't look me up if you come to Paris. Will you be there in 2 weeks?
Oh, who knows?
How do you look her up? Are you here? No number, no nothing.
Nobody has done that to me in 15 years.
Not even Borkov. And I'm sober as a judge, as Alma would say.
I myself am not. Night.
Night.
Wait, hey. Do you still like my hair?
Oh my god.
Well, that changed really fast.
That's
so.
So are you saying that Harry was bad?
You should play the Sicilian.
What?
In your game with Borgov, you should play the Sicilian.
He's thinking about chess.
And like she probably is too.
Why? It's what he's so good at.
It's also what you're most comfortable with. You play what's best for you.
Thank you. Anything else?
One more thing. They never say check at the big tournaments.
Are you serious? This is what you're thinking about right now?
You did this to Harry too, girl.
Yeah, but for once in her life, she was thinking about something else. She wasn't obsessed about chess. But he is obsessed about chess too.
Honey, this is what it feels like to be with you.
But maybe that's gonna maybe help her have some reality check.
Monsieur Borger, what's it like to compete with the younger players? And how much longer do you think you'll play?
Я чувствую себя хорошо. Так же хорошо, как когда мне было 4 года. Я играл свою первую игру.
You think he's thinking about retiring?
As good as I felt when I was 4 years old and played my first game. I have no plans to stop playing.
Okay.
And I'll likely die with my head on the chessboard.
Miss Harmon. What do you say to those in the Chess Federation who accuse you of being too glamorous to be a serious chess player?
I would say that it's much easier to play chess without the burden of an Adam's apple.
Miss Harmon, do you feel good about the rematch with Grandmaster Borgo?
Very good. I slept on the plane, so I arrived in Paris with no jet lag. I'm very well-rested. At night, I stay in my room and study Mr. Borgov's old games.
Including the one against you in Mexico City?
Asobina, feto.
Oh! But the jet lag comment, too, is about something they said. But then what's gonna happen that's gonna send her in the first episode? We know there's a guy that shows up eventually, so...
Hello? What, you thought you could sneak into town without me knowing?
Unless it's not a guy.
Unless it's not a guy.
I thought you might come down and join me for a drink.
Oh yeah.
I have a match.
I think that's gonna be Cleo in the bed, that's for sure.
Yeah, but one drink is a slippery slope.
I should probably sleep.
Of course you should. I understand.
But maybe tomorrow night?
Well, who knows where I'll be so far in the future, but I wish you luck in your match.
Don't fall. Don't do anything.
Thank you.
You know, it's a lovely bar. I think I'll go toast your success on my own.
We know where this leads. This leads. Fuck. So disappointed when we knew where this was gonna go.
The thing is, she wanted to try to stay sober and to focus on what was happening.
Must be special if
but yeah.
Mademoiselle, vous attend.
Je descends tout de suite, okay?
Doesn't make things better.
Thank you.
And if this fucks up her chances, honestly though, she'll only have herself to blame.
I'm sorry.
Yeah. Well, they couldn't start.
She's fucking like she's on edge, and she's hungover. Mm. That's cool. Take the whole thing.
She must be.
She's probably
stressed out.
No, but she's probably stressing him out too.
Oh my god! This looks like she's about to cry.
Mistake. He's just done.
I resign.
You don't know that.
I don't believe that. What time do you get in? I can come pick you up.
I'm going back to Lexington. I need to be alone.
That is the opposite of what you need. Beth.
Thank you, Benny. For everything.
You shouldn't be by yourself. You know what happens.
Maybe that's what I want.
Want to get drunk?
Yeah. Getting drunk. Fucking bombed. And maybe high too. Why not?
What if I said, okay, go ahead, get drunk. Would you come then?
Benny, I don't know what I'm doing. We're going to do.
She refused that glass. I mean, she got so emotionally invested in that fucking game. I think she might be starting to realize that what she's doing is bad. But now what is she gonna do next?